So it's not hard to tell that our buddy here is not feeling so well, right? He's kind of look like he's seen better days. So let's just pretend for a second. We're going to use our imagination to work through diagnosing and treating a pneumonia. So let's say that you're working in a doctor's office and this guy walks in, and I think we should give him a name. Let's call him Paul. I just feel like when you give an animation a name, somehow it becomes real, okay? So let's say that Paul comes in to see you, and Paul says, I've been having this cough. So here's this cough. So I've been having this terrible cough, and sometimes I bring up something with it. So sometimes I have some nasty stuff that comes out of it. So I'm going to draw some sputum there so you can see sometimes he's coughing out some mucus, and sometimes it's dry. And then let's say, you know what? He says that, oh gosh, I can't breathe. You know, I'm really having a hard time breathing, and I'm really short of breath. And so you get this information from Paul, and you start to think to yourself, you know what? This sounds a lot like pneumonia. So if you suspect that based off of the information that he's given you, based off of these clues and this data, well, how do we go about diagnosing pneumonia? And so that's kind of what we're going to talk about. We're going to talk about diagnosing pneumonia. So I'm actually going to make two little lists down here. I'm going to have a diagnostic tests that we can do to check for pneumonia, and labs. And by labs, I really mean like collecting specimens, whereas diagnostics would be like a procedure, right? So before we get into that, let's just make sure that our brains are ready to talk about pneumonia. So I'm going to come over here, and I'm just going to kind of erase away a pair of lungs. And let's pretend that these are Paul's lungs. So what do we know about pneumonia? Remember that pneumonia is a lung infection, right? So I have his right, his left lung. We got my trachea here, right? And that branches off into my right and to my left bronchus or main airway. And then that branches off to even smaller airways and even smaller airways. And those are our bronchioles. And then we can see at the very end of all of this, we have these tiny air sacs. And we call those alveoli. And I'm going to write that because it's certainly not a term that we see too often. So these tiny air sacs, this is actually where all the gas exchange happens. So what does that mean? That means that as we're breathing in, and let's make this a nice color blue. So as we're breathing in, I don't think you can see that too well. Let me go for a darker blue. That's better. So as we're breathing in air, right? Breathing, breathing, breathing. It's going to get all the way to the end, to our alveoli. Well, what happens here is that the oxygen is absorbed into our blood system because we've got these tiny capillaries that run beneath our and around, beneath and around, I should say, our alveoli. So that oxygen is absorbed into our blood system, and then we actually have an exchange. Then we're going to have let me pick a different color. And then we're gonna have carbon dioxide being picked up and excreted out. So the process is that we breathe in the oxygen, right? So we breathe in O2, and we're going to exhale CO2. And that happens here. That happens in our alveoli. So as you can see, I've painted these green so you can imagine that it's filled with this fluid. And this is infected fluid. And that's infected fluid secondary to an organism that's caused us to be ill. And that can either be a virus, that could be a bacteria, that could be a fungus. It could be any organism that can cause disease. And we call that pathogens. So long and short of pneumonia is that it really is an infection of our lung. However, the infection is occurring here in our air sacs or our alveoli, and that infection causes an inflammatory response that fills up those air sacs with this nasty material. The nasty material is taking up the space of where we should have air exchange happening. So now with that said, in his symptoms, you can see that they kind of go hand in hand and it's making sense. This is what led us to believe he might have pneumonia. So let's talk about some diagnostic tests. The first thing that we can do, and I'm going to abbreviate this, CXR, would be a chest x-ray. And a chest x-ray is going to allow us to actually look inside Paul's chest. So just like I can see here, right? With the naked eye, I can't see inside of his chest. I can't see his lungs at all. But with the chest x-ray, I can actually see inside and I'll be able to visualize his lungs. And what we'd be doing is looking for some type of fluid or inflammation in the lungs. Another thing that we can do to visualize would be a CT scan. And this is very similar to a chest x-ray, and I'm just going to write this here, a CT scan, except the difference is that this is a more detailed visualization of the lungs. See, an x-ray will give us a black and white image just of dense areas and less dense areas, so like bone and air and fluid as well. Whereas a CT scan, I'd be able to see tissues. If we wanted to move forward and do some things that were a little bit more invasive, we can do a bronchoscopy. And I'm writing these terms because it's not too often that we actually see them. And I think it's important that we get familiar with it if we're going to talk about diagnosing and treating pneumonia. So I'm going to show you what a bronchoscopy looks like. But first, I want to erase this stuff because we already talked about his cough, right? We talked about his protective cough. We talked about his symptoms. So a bronchoscopy is a procedure where we actually take a thin, flexible tube, and this is a device, and we feed this device either through the mouth, so through Paul's mouth, down through his trachea, into his main airway, or we could do it through the nose as well and end up in the same place. Of course, Paul's gonna be asleep for this. And at the end of this device, we have a camera. So I'm gonna make this little black dot, and that's gonna be like my camera. And what a bronchoscopy is going to allow is that the person on the other end, or in this case, it's gonna be the physician, is actually gonna be able to see inside of the airways. And they can tell if there's excess mucus present, if there's a blockage, if there's a tumor. So a bronchoscopy really is the method for us to visualize what's happening in the lungs. A fourth thing we can do, which I also say is invasive because it involves actually going inside the body, is a bronchoalveolar, talk about a big word, lavage. And this is done in the same manner as a bronchoscopy. However, the difference is instead of us just going in here to look, we're actually going in there to collect. And so instead of this camera, we're actually going to instill some fluid. So you see these blue lines? That's normal saline. We're gonna instill fluid into the airway, and we're going to then collect that fluid because what's happened is that fluid was able to mix with all the other substances and the contents of the airway. We can collect the fluid and we can test it to see if there's any organisms present. And that's gonna help us to indicate what's causing this infection. Now, if we come down here, we can talk a little bit more about labs. Now, remember Paul said that he was coughing up some nasty sputum? Well, we can actually test that sputum. So here's my sputum. So he said that he was coughing up some sputum, and we can actually test that to see what grows. And we call that a sputum culture. Another lab that we can do would be to do a blood culture. So I'm just making these little red droplets here to indicate blood. And just as we do a sputum culture to check the sputum for organisms, we're gonna check the blood for organisms. And again, both of these things are going to let us know what exactly is causing the problem. So is it a virus that's causing the problem? Is it a bacteria that's causing the problem? What's the organism that's causing the problem? And just as a side note, viral pneumonia is the most common cause of all pneumonias. So now that we've done these diagnostic tests, and now that we've done these labs, we're actually now ready to treat it. So let's make a treat column. How do we treat it, right? So if it's caused by a bacteria, our treatment choice is going to be an antibiotic. So these here are just gonna represent some pills. So we're gonna give an antibiotic medication to Paul to help kill that bacteria. If it's caused by a virus, unfortunately, there's no treatment for a viral infection. We're really just treating the symptoms. So that means that we wanna keep Paul as comfortable as possible. And there are some ways that we can do that. One of the ways we want to treat the symptoms is to promote and to encourage hydration. That means we really want Paul to be drinking as much fluid as possible. So there's my glass of water. In addition to keeping him hydrated, drinking a lot of fluids is going to help thin out the secretions. So remember this kind of like glob of sputum that I made? Well, by increasing the amount of fluid that we intake, we can actually thin this out. And that's a good thing because the thinner it is, the easier it's going to be for Paul to cough it out of his airway. Another thing that we can do is we can provide oxygen. Now I'm gonna make a cloud, and this cloud's going to represent oxygen. And in cases that pneumonia is severe enough, oxygen absorption can be severely impaired. So it's really important that we can provide supplemental oxygen to make sure the body has the O2 that it needs to function. And then one last thing that I wanna add is something that we call CPT. And so I'm gonna come over here and I'm gonna write CPT, and we can make that our number 3 thing. And I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna make these little like these vibration marks next to it, because that's what I want you to think of when you hear CPT. Now CPT stands for chest physiotherapy. And what happens in this case is that a trained professional is actually going to use their hands, and they cup their hands. Did I make the right amount of fingers? I hope so. So they're going to cup their hands and they're going to tap on the patient's back and their chest. And you know what this is for? This is actually to help break up the secretions that they have in their airway so that it's easier for the patient to cough it out.